Well, I found the car through a friend because I sold an old Firebird back about 4 years ago, and the guy came to look at it, pulled up in this car. He was looking at it for a friend, and I saw the car, and then, you know, when I was ready to buy a new car, I rang him up to see what he got to offer, and went over and had a look at it, and ended up buying it off him. It looked pretty, but as all pretty things go, they needed a lot of work to get it up and running to make it drivable. There was a lot of teething problems, especially in the undercarriage, and I had months and months of painstaking work to rebuild the undercarriage to make it work and drive with no squeaks and no bumps and stop. And finally, after all those teething problems were cleared, then I had a chance to work on the body. Always the intention to have a Pro Tourer. Won't have anything other than a Pro Tourer. My last car was a Pro Tourer, and they're just my thing.
How often do you get to use it?
I drive it every weekend without fail, and during the week, once or twice, go for lunch or coffee, I drive it all the time. I get people nearly break their necks stopping to turn around to have a look at it. And then, believe it or not, it's usually the elderly couples that give me the high five or the thumbs up, you know, people over 60 and 70s. They're always just going, cool car, mate. Well, it's an LS1, stroked and blown with a Magna Charger blower on it with 9 pounds. When I first bought it, it hadn't been tuned, so I was running all over the place, and the computer was locked, so I couldn't get into the computer to tune it. But CMV Performance helped me with unlocking the computer, and we dynoed it and fixed all the problems, and you know, we got about an extra 60, 70 horsepower out of it. So it's got about 450 horsepower at the wheels. Very reliable. There wasn't when I first bought it. It used to break down and blow fuses, and the engine would cut out, and I could never work out what it was. And until I went underneath the dash and saw the bird nest under there wiring and sorted out. And my friend Artie, who's a genius at wiring, helped me, and we put proper fuses all in the one spot so we can know where they are when they blow. And touch wood, since then it hasn't had a problem. I just 98 octane.
That's good on fuel.
I don't care. No, it's finished. Finally finished.
If you were to do it again, would you change anything?
No, I wouldn't. That's how I envisioned it to turn out like. Well, Brian from Bonneville Automotive in Cogra, he's a genius when it comes to troubleshooting. I thank him for all the help, and Artie, my auto electrician, and Marcelo, who spent days and days slicing the car back and buffing it after the panel shop. Twice he did it. And I'd like to thank my wife for putting up with me, because I was always in the garage all day, every day. Hi, my name's Paul, and this is my 69 Camaro, and you're watching Killer Rides.